एकोंकार सतनाम करता पुरख निरपौ निर्वैर अकाल मूरत अजूनी सैभं गुर प्रसाद जप आद सच।
We will tell this story to almost anyone he meets and he is bubbling with energy when he is doing any of his film. And what I find, as I work with so many other directors also, that he improvises a lot when he is doing his scenes. He might think of doing a particular scene in the morning in a certain manner, but by the time he comes on the set, he has changed the entire kind of thinking as far as shooting of the scene is concerned. Although the scene remains the same, but then he will, like only 2 days back in the morning when we were coming in the car, and he says that the scene is very important in the film because there's a lot of tension in the scene and all that. But then the shooting wise, you know, it will be a very kind of simple kind of shooting, not much of a camera movement and all that. And when we went on the set, started doing that scene, almost all the shots are quite camera movement, you know. So it's a, you know, what I say is, when he is working, he improvises a lot. Nothing is fixed from the beginning, you know. So that is what I like about him. And that's the reason I think I also got a chance to do improvise my kind of work.
But don't you find it difficult as a cameraman to work in such an improvised situation?
No, it's not, because if you preset the things, then it is difficult. But then I don't preset any things because I also work according to the requirements given at the spot. Say when he explains the scene to me in the morning, then I think of doing that plan of lighting, then I decide. So it's not difficult. In fact, I enjoy doing things like that.
When did you first meet him? How did he come in contact with you?
I think it was in 1966. I remember exact date because it was my convocation, 5th of August 1966. And he had come to Pune Film Institute. And on that day, I think he saw my diploma film also, on that particular day. And he liked the film very much. I don't know whether he liked the film very much, but he liked my work in that. Especially there's one handheld shot in the train corridor. So that day only, in fact, he said, he promised me that someday we'll be working definitely together. Of course, the chance came after 3 years.
And the first film you worked with him was Bhuvan Shom.
Yes.
Do you remember Bhuvan Shom?
Yeah, very much.
How was it? What was it like? And that being your first major film?
Yeah, in fact, we worked in a lot of handicaps because the budget of the film was very low. Like, I was not even provided any light boys or things like that. But still, we enjoyed working. And we used to do things in whatever manner we could manage. Like, even direction boys or production boys helping in holding the reflectors and things like that. And of course, the locations were very beautiful. That helped the film a lot. And whatever interior we had, that also we did on location with very few lights. But then I think the results were, he was quite happy with the results. Of course, in the beginning, he even called me a documentary cameraman because first time when he saw the rushes, he didn't like it very much. That was a mistake of the lab, but then afterwards when the reprint was done, it was okay.
What was the first shot of Bhuvan Shom you took?
I think Utpal coming out of the railway station it was, he gets into a tonga. I think that was the first scene.
Was there any difficult shots you remember which was very challenging as a cameraman?
Nothing, like, you know, I'll say that it's the situation which puts the thing into difficult shots. Like, we had a camera trolley, but that trolley didn't have any tracks. So we had to work with improvised with planks and things like that. So working with those things, you know, In the initial thing, you feel bad that you don't have a proper equipment to work with. But when you think that, but there's no choice. So out of that, whatever is given to you, you have to do your best. So I'll say that that was one thing. Like, you know, there were a lot of movement. They are moving on a bullock cart. So a lot of trolley shots were there. But then we had to do all with the planks and things like that.
How was that done? That was done on a rough track. How was this plank taken as
well? So we'll use planks, put them together, try to balance them as much as possible, and then use a trolley on top of it.
In subsequent films, what changes have you seen? Have you seen any change in his style?
Yeah, very much, because since Ekdin Pratidin, I think he has gone on analyzing his characters more than on the other subject. Because most of his films after Ekdin Pratidin are study of characters, analysis of the characters. And since then, most of his films have been like that. But before Ekdin Pratidin, his films were quite different.
As a cameraman, do you see any change in terms of the types of shot taking from Bhuvan Shom till now?
Yeah, now he uses a lot of camera movement. That much he was not using earlier. And the camera movement, the way he uses, has a rhythm in them. In totality, when you see the scene, it has a rhythm. So this, I think, is from last 8-9 years. Previously, it was not there.
Can you think of any shot or any sequence in all the Minal Sen films which you think was very, very difficult to execute, but which was executed?
No, I don't know whether you will remember. There is one shot in Akale Sandane. It's a very long shot, nearly 380 feet. And lots of characters are involved in that, and a lot of camera movement is there. He planned that shot, and we executed that shot very effectively. If you remember, I'll say it's near a temple, outside a temple, some people have gathered, and then other characters come and go.
Over the years, you've worked with a lot of new directors, especially new cinema directors.
Yes.
What difference do you find with him and the other directors?
As I told you earlier, mainly he improvises a lot on the set, whereas the other directors, they are quite fastidious. Like I'll mention Kumar, Harmani. They are very particular about things, and if the things don't happen in that manner, they will not take the shot and all that. Whereas in case of Dada, he, according to the situation, he'll adjust. Not that he'll lose the quality of the shot or the scene, but he'll ready to adjust according to the situation. And of course, he's very sure. There are many new directors who are very confused. And in case of Dada, the main reason I'll say I like the way he improvises on the set. That's the main difference between him
this
and me.
Improvisation, is it, can you predict him?
No.
You can't. You have worked in so many films.
Yeah.
Are you in a position to say that he's going to take a scene, will be broken up like this or will be taken like this?
No, you can't predict, because he acts on the spur of the moments. When he's there on the set with the scene, he starts thinking at that moment. Not that he must not have thought about the scene earlier, but how to take the scene, he thinks when he's on the set. So my piece, you see, I just now before lunch, he explained me a shot. So if I go and set up the shot, quite possible he'll come and change the shot. He'll say, no, I want a track or something like that. So that kind of thing keeps on working in his mind.
Which is your favorite Minal Sen film? And why?
Work of, definitely I like
as a cameraman.
Khandar, I like it very much. And in black and white, I like Calcutta Family.
Why was Khanda so important to you?
One thing, the location was very beautiful. Then there were a lot of lighting effects which the picture demanded and which we executed, which came out well. And of course, location helped a lot. It was, I'll say, for any cameraman, location is very important, and Khanda location was very beautiful. Calcutta 71 was in black and white, and it had five different stories set in it, five different kind of things. So that, as a cameraman, gave me a lot of scope to work differently. If you see this, you will find that. five different kind of facts now. Even within me, there is.
That is a very emotional man, and you are also a very emotional man. How do you both get along then? Up shooting, when you are not shooting?
We got along very well with each other. While shooting, of course, sometimes there is some tension, but when we are not working, there is no tension at all.
Thank you.